approach to when they're on the Radiant, they always pick a way to be able to get into that Roshan pit and steal it from the Dire sides. They're one of the few teams that when they're on Radiant, they have that massive potential to just go in there and take it when it's usually the opposite way around.
Okay, final thoughts, Johnny?
Man, I really like Liquid's draft here. It has so much setup and initiation, and it's, like I said earlier, very fast. You can just, you hit your levels and just go in.
I agree. I really like Liquid's draft. It just seems like they have a little bit of an edge coming out in the laning phase as well versus OG. The Darkseer is going to be able to pressure a bit on the Lycan, but Dust Disruptor is quite great versus that.
Yeah, I agree. I like Liquid's draft. The one gem that OG has going for them, Earth Spirit, Darkseer, they've got to crush the safe lane.
They've got to crush
if they don't do that, they're going to get behind in fights.
Absolutely.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, gentlemen. We'll get more thoughts, of course, from our expert panel at the end of Game 2. If you're just joining us, welcome to the Manila Major Grand Final, Game number 2. Let's head back to the commentators. Eldian Gods.
Thank you very much, Paul. Gods, analysts, favoring Liquid again in Game 2 are you.
Up until the last pick, Darkseer, definitely, I was like, how did Liquid get all these heroes in their draft? The Darkseer, though, very good at upsetting the Liquid lanes, because when you're running that greedy jungle Beastmaster, you have to do something to punish it.
All right, well, with that, the punishment might be getting out, guys. Game 2 is underway.
And here we are. Already, teams have moved out to the lanes. You can see some early wards did get dropped. Don't think either of these were scouted. And actually, a total of 3 early wards as Miracle is dancing on top of one. So Liquid, they don't have the Bounty Hunter this game. They don't have the Riki, rather, that Invis here. They can run around and drop incredibly deep wards, but they still have some good vision to start this one off.
Yeah, and Liquid, they see that Earth Spirit Phoenix and know that this support your Earth Spirit roams around, pressures the lanes a bit, but it's not the most like proactive duo, with Phoenix kind of having to sit and doesn't rotate all that well. So as a result, they get this Beastmaster, but Iron Shell Earth Spirit, very disruptive, very difficult for Lycan to lane against when he's not going to get any help from one of his supports. Only the Disruptor can try and help this lane out.
So is that the lane you want to see Crit focusing on if you're OG? Is it really just the Lycan you look to shut down?
I think you swing from mid and bottom. You want to be spending a lot of time. If you're in the Radiant jungle, you can do 3 things. You can pressure the Beastmaster jungle, which he's often on low HP for. You can rotate mid and go on Fata with a Juggernaut who has quite a decent amount of kill potential. And you can partner up with a Darkseer to disrupt Lycan's farm. So there's a ton of options for Earth Spirit, and it's much easier to play a hero like Earth Spirit when there's 3 different lanes you can pressure, or 2 lanes plus a jungle. If there's only 1 lane you can gank, it's very obvious where Earth Spirit's going to camp the entire early game. But this game, the world is his oyster.
Yeah, he will be starting bottom here, just parked behind Moon, looking to ensure that they get the early roll, and they do. Moving on to Matumba Man. Just a little bit of pressure, but with the double Ion Shell, one now expiring on the creeps, they can really look to shut down the Lycan before he gets scary, and this is those early moments where Lycan doesn't do all that much.
Yeah, and Liquid's response is going to be try and use that pull camp to deny XP and also force the creep wave under the tower, because Matumba Man can farm. He's going to be able to farm a lot easier under his tower with his regen and stout shield than he is out in the lane, but the response to this from OG is just to go for a pull camp of their own.
Yeah, we did see briefly, it is just a full Iron Talon jungle Beastmaster. It's been talked about a lot by the analysts, by many of the players, that we heard it from PPD yesterday on the panel, that they just think Beastmaster is broken right now. And if he's getting free farm in the jungle, I'm not sure anyone does it faster, not even Enigma necessarily. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, he has been found now by Crit. We talked about how he's got plenty of options as far as where he can rotate to. In some ways, Kuro does act as a buffer towards that mid lane protecting Fata, but if you ever manage to sneak past the Beastmaster and get like a level 2, level 3 spin, or even like hit that level 6 timing on Jug, kills onto DK, very possible.
The good news, though, for OG is Miracle having a better start than last game. We saw him a bit slow as far as farm went in that tri lane and the off lane. They eventually somewhat abandoned it, but he is free farming against the Dragonite on a hero that scales quite well, is up against a lot of armor, a lot of tanky heroes, so not an easy game to take over with Omni Slash, but if anyone can do it, it's probably Miracle.
Yeah, the result of this, though, is Mind Control's offlane slider will get farm as well as XP out of this lane.
Yeah, Notail getting bullied a bit here. He's already used that time walk. Mind Control diving him. Big Daddy, he gets crushed. In comes the Phoenix, and that will be enough to zone him out. Can they get the counter kill? Nope, Mind Control will walk away, so Big Daddy under the gun early here. He is slightly out farming, but Hotel.
He wants to get this CS at his tower, but needs to make sure he can actually salve up. And that was a really nice play by Mind Control. Almost gets that kill until the Phoenix heal comes into play.
Yeah, doesn't know he has the backup, but still, Slardar having a lot of impact early on in this offlane. You compare that to the bottom lane, Lycan 12-3, despite the dual lane aggression with the Darkseer. They are getting some good side pulls for Moon here, but they're not really shutting down the Lycan just yet, Gods.
Yeah, by no means. Moon will be getting farm and levels himself, but not exactly the outcome they were perhaps hoping for out of this lane. And
is there anything they can do to play this one better?
I mean, at this point, you're kind of, you are where you are. This Lycan has his boots up very nice and early, something you often don't see for a free farming Lycan, but against this aggressive dual lane, the boots go a long way in.
And it's always the power of the Disruptor. You roll on him, he can just glimpse one of the two back, and suddenly you don't have necessarily the kill potential.
Yeah. I think with the level 4 on Lycan already, you're better off trying to pressure
the
mid lane.
Trying to chase that Earth Spirit out of the jungle. Crit does get caged again. It's the Disruptor setting things up. Kuro going to work with the axes there, but not able to finish him off still with the 4-minute rune coming soon. That's a very low HP support to try and contest.
Why is backing up mid? And this is the adaptation from Crit, is that he wanted to rotate mid and get a rolling boulder off. He hits the rolling boulder. There's not just Blade Fury, but also a Sunray and a slow from dive. But unfortunately, Kuro's Beastmaster has just been on point with the Hawk positioning and constantly scouted out these rotations. But Crit has still found himself in a good position.
And they roll in, they move on to Fada. OG looking to strike first here. In game one, it was a double kill and a first blood for Liquid. In game two, it's the boys in green that get out to the hotter start.
Yeah. They've done great up until that point, but...
And an instant smoke, Gods. They want to make this two in a row.
Yeah, Kuro did stop those earlier rotations mid, but Crit just realizes, rather than try and flank from behind the tower, just go from your own T1 tower, and a much harder rotation to get vision of.
And this is the time to do it, before the Beastmaster fully comes online. He is up there with the cores as far as CSGO, but they're rolling in. Connection on Matumba Man, not yet level 6. OG are going to find themselves another kill. The glimpse back a bit too late. Can they punish Crit on the way out? Tower shot with the Wolves might be enough to finish him as Moon threatens to dive onto Jerex here. These Wolves are bringing Crit down though, and he will end up falling. Now they turn on to Fly. They are very low. Don't see them getting that second kill, but it's still overall 1-for-1, but the Lycan dying for an Earth Spirit. And OG killing off two cores here before the Beastmaster starts moving.
OG's now put themselves in a position where two and really all three of their lanes are going very well. The Void free farming for the most
another roll, another jump. They still don't have that Beastmaster roar. He's very close. They're diving onto Fada. Omni Slash is ready. Fada does get off the dragon till Miracle tried to back up to prevent this, but he's got the phase boots to chase. Omni comes through, decapitates the knight.
It was
off with your helm.
A great turn from Fata to get the stun off before Omni Slash, but
and now
couldn't quite get far enough away
like
because of
phase. Looks like they might go top here. No-Tail has the chrono.
And OG are just moving so well with these two supports.
And now they want to try and deal with Mind Control. They get the Bash, the Chrono comes through, meets the Sunray Mind Control. Doesn't even need Crit's help. OG have killed all three cores. Then they're looking for Jerex too. He TP'd in a bit late to the party. No-Tail still beating him down. He needs that Bash. Give me a Bash, he says. Give me a Bash already. Ice Frog, please. There you go.
He's overextended though.
He might die for this though. No-Tail into the trees. The roar actually goes onto Crit, so they're going to settle for a support kill. No-Tail has the time walk out. Should be able to survive just barely at that. But they chase for more. Suddenly Miracle joins the fray. OG with the relentless aggression. They take the fight to Liquid. They look to punish before that big death ball push begins, but Miracle getting dealt with by the boar here. He really needs help. No-Tail's also low. The healing ward's dealt with. Mind Control gets the one hero crush. The time walk forward. The bash from Big Daddy. Is he going to get a second? Can't quite. Even Moon chasing.
And Miracle's a regen rune. He TP's mid. He might be able to go for this kill. Doesn't have Omni Slash though. Probably doesn't have the A. He's going to just go for the farm. Doesn't have the damage.
Still right back to full HP. Free fountain trip for him. And even after all that, it's still Liquid within striking distance. And we've yet to see the too much movement from the Beastmaster. Just reactionary there to top. They're giving Matumba Man more space now, Gods. And despite the pressure bottom, he leads the CS charts, but for now, OG leading with this lineup that scales very well into late game. They've got to be happy about that.
Liquid's always been about that mid game. Like, with a drop like this, it's always about that mid game push. So an early game where they're a little bit behind in a couple of kills before they've even picked up the Vlads, before they've got Mind Control's Blink, they're not going to be overly concerned, but there is that slight sense of worry where OG now have the momentum. They're just executing their rotations incredibly well, and if they can maintain that, Liquid at some point are going to have to find a way to respond. They can't just sit back and expect to reach that mid game without taking more and more casualties if they play completely defensively.
Yeah, at this point, Roar back up, waiting on the Dragon Idol, but a successful movement by Liquid probably means a tower down, at least a glyph forced out, and some significant damage done there. So Fada, he's closing in on that. Meanwhile, Nambi slash Miracle, moving on to Mind Control. Can he finish him here? Almost in range. The phase boot's now activated. He gets off the Blade Fury, but he tries to slither away. Ain't gonna happen. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Matumbo Man dead as well. OG making all the right moves. Bullying Liquid. Just slurping them up.
And the great thing about all these OG kills is it's not like they're five-man rotations. We saw last game when they fell behind early, it was like 10, 15 minutes in, they five-man smoke gank top. No, OG are finding these kills with two heroes. In that case, at mid, the Jug just does it all by himself. Bottom lane, it's only a three-hero commitment, so they're doing it in a very efficient way where they're not over-committing, they're still maintaining their farm. Three heroes with 45-plus CS. It's only the Lycan Radiant's who's ahead of those three OG cores, and they're now in a position where they can follow up these kills with objectives.
Mid lane. On to Miracle, goes for the TP out the Roar.
Oh no.
A whiff there from him, and it means Miracle gets out. But Matumbo Man races in. The quick Icarus dive back and to turn their attention onto the Samurai. Can they bring Miracle down? The Fire Spirit's coming through. Miracle will fall despite the mistake from Kuro. And Liquid still able to transition into a push. Shows you just how good their ability to take objectives really is. But now the roll, crit, counter initiated. He's got the ultimate as well. He's going to drop it too. Starting to bring Kuro low. They're going to scatter Kuro to the north. And it looks like Beastmaster will fall. And meanwhile, Matumbo with the wall working against him. Moon, he's got the surge. It's on the like an illusion. It turns into a wolf, but it gets him too.
Mama OG would be proud of that one.
You never ever run from me, says Moon.
Well,
4-11, gods.
That was a great turnaround coming out from OG. They did lose the void at bottom lane while that was all going on. It looks like a Fata TP from Dragonite. He had that double damage rune, and that's where Liquid, when they get that pick off, they're so dangerous. A Beastmaster and the double damage dragon form pose a lot of threat to the tower, but with OG responding mid, Fata finds the pick off at bottom.
And that's with a Roar and a creep. They still manage to do that much damage to the tower.
And it's also some space for Mind Control. This is the player who won't be able to really be all too active or get involved until he has a Blink Dagger, so a bit more pressure on Kuro to get involved with Fata's Dragon Knight and create some space for Mind Control just to get...
Hello, Kuro says no tail. He found not one, but two, and they're working on Kuro. He's going to drop very early in this fight. Mind Control gets up the amp, crushes, and runs.
Yeah.
Constantly on the defensive. It's a total role reversal from last game.
Really curious what Notel's going with the Perseverance pickup. We'll see Miracle
play. It's safe here. He knows there's really no way to cancel that with the Beastmaster dead. So he will make it out, but Dragon Knight ult online again. Do Liquid look to push with this? They bring Matumbo Man into the mid lane, so we've seen a lot from this team when they're running heroes like the Lycan, the Death Prophet. They like to take these early crucial towers, especially the tier 1 mid.
Yeah.
Well, do OG defend? They don't have a chrono.
Have got the magnetized, but they're not going to rotate. They
insta smoke, but
were they too close? They were very close to the creep, so the Miracle will pop it in.
He's got the Blade Fury as well. He can easily get out from Jerax here, even if there's a glimpse. Trying to bait the Blade Fury and chase further, but Miracle showing good patience there.
Really heads up play by Miracle. As soon as he sees the smoke, he just positions himself on the high ground too. Reveal the smoke and then get himself back to safety.
And they're farming elsewhere. OG doing a good job at spreading the map. You can see Crit getting some crucial me time on the bottom lane. Notel farming up the woods has gone for the early Perseverance.
Yeah,
so is his Battle Fury.
And Battle Fury is really the only item that makes sense, but it's a very greedy approach to take considering you've done so well in the early game. And I think going Battle Fury against this scary mid-game push of the Lycan, Dragonite, Beastmaster, to me, is very risky. Now, since picking it up, he did get the Ring of Aquila, so he bought the Aquila after the Perseverance. I'm not sure if that means he's thinking about changing his mind or what, but Notel does recognize he needs some early-game presence.
Now, in good news for OG, they have a little balance here from Miracles. He is not rushing a Battle Fury of his own. We have seen him do that on the Jug sometimes, but feels like an early Yasha will be the pickup for him. Gets the Band of Elven Skin, and now OG. They will smoke. They will move top after getting a essentially free tier 1. They've got all their ultimates online aside from the Chrono, cooling down soon. Both teams popping scans here.
And recognizing that Liquid's kind of taken over their jungle, this is the very common play to make after getting a tier 1 tower, and they may they don't go back, fully commit to going in their jungle.
Crit might find someone, but he needs the team with him. They're hesitating. Now they're moving top. OG rolling in. They found Jerax, the Static Storm deployed defensively. Looks for the TP out, and he gets the glyphs off on the Phoenix. He'll make it out too. So Jerax dodges a bullet.
Everyone gets out of that one.
Even Matumba Man TPing away. Still nothing too big used there by OG, just a smoke. They don't blow a Chrono or anything like that. They're still the team that's somewhat penned in on their side of the map.
Yeah, and for Liquid, they haven't really hit all their item timings just yet. They yet to get any of the Necro books on either. Well, Beastmaster's got his back at base. Lycan still working on his Necro 1. So for Liquid, you get scary around like the double Necro book stage. They don't even have to be level 3. Level 1, level 2 with Fata, who's very tanky with this armlet now. And then you just kind of 5-minute towers. We saw them take the tier 1 mid without resistance. And then instantly, in the same dragon form, they got another tier 1 tower up top. So when you can get two towers from the one ultimate, you kind of know your opponents are very reliant on some of their ultimates, like the Chronosphere.
OG do have a nice ward here. Actually, three off on the Radiant side. But most importantly, that one bottom. Scouted out Kuroki and Fauna. Kuroki and Fauna showing good map awareness. Do retreat long before that potential gank could materialize. I'll reveal No-Tail in the bottom lane. The rest of the team parked behind him. Liquid seemed content to farm. Lycan off at the Ancients. The rest of the team was in the lanes, now in the jungle. And they are keeping this game stable. As good of a start as it was for OG, it's only a 2,000 gold lead. That's just one good fight and a tower from Liquid, and it will be erased.
And they're just kind of sticking near each other. The Dragonite, who was kind of closer to the lane, still has his three teammates nearby. It's only ever going to be Matumba Man, who might be off kind of on his own, getting some farm. As he is probably the one who's most kind of late-game item-dependent for the team. The other four ready to fight may even look for a smoke gank soon, although two dire wards have given plenty of vision of this Liquid squad, and Liquid had like a couple centuries expire, and they smoke under a ward.
OG are ready for this. They smoke too. This one not scouted. Liquid heading north, OG sneaking south, creeping in behind them. They are going to forfeit a potential high ground advantage there. I think they're expecting Liquid to be in the pit, Gods. Maybe.
They're likely to wrap around towards that pit soon. Miracle will see his smoke not pop and should know what's going on now that Liquid is smoked into their own jungle. So despite seeing the smoke, it doesn't set them up for a teamfight victory immediately.
And No-Tail, not under cover of smoke. He is visible. That Faceless Void, and it looks like in the end, a swing and a miss for both teams.
Yeah. I mean, for Liquid, they had triple sentries in their own jungle, and they just assumed that OG had limited vision in this Radiant jungle, but OG had two Observer Wards go unnoticed.
Well, speaking of unnoticed Observer Wards, now Liquid, they have the vision advantage here. They're moving the Wolf Pack in. Kuroki leading the charge for now. Fata with the Haste Rune and the Armlet. Both teams want a clean initiation, neither finding it, but the vision advantage has to be on the side of Liquid as far as the heroes go.
And when you have a vision advantage with a disruptor, it's so scary to play against. That's where OG, even though with this strong team fight, you're looking at Chronosphere with a Darkseer, a Supernova.
Do you get it off?
Yeah, do you get it off? Is it Liquid getting the jump? If they manage to get a roar and burst someone down, the mana burn from the Necro Book could mean the Void doesn't even have mana to time walk away, something that Kevin talked about on the panel as well, and that makes it very difficult for OG to play.
There's the roll in, but Jerax is ready for it, dropping the Static Storm here, not a very good one, and he's going to get caught out. Will be finished off with a Blade Fury for Miracle. Crit may pay in return, though, as he commits a Magnetized Mind Control, bringing him down together with the Wolves. They are chasing Mind Control, but he's rather far away. Matumba Man coming into Wolf form and then says, "Get out of my way, Fata!" Get out of there. So they decide to back off. They lose a Disruptor. They trade him for an Earth Spirit. Support for support. But Liquid playing a little scared. Don't want to walk into that team fight.
Yeah. I've got plenty of setup for the Glimpse using those Lycan Wolves and the Beastmaster Hawk, but OG have just not given Liquid any opportunities to find those pickoffs. And Earth Spirit at best is all they've managed to really get this game. And following that kill, OG themselves go into the pit, soon to be scattered out by a Hawk.
Now, do Liquid walk into that pit? The Lycan ultimate at these early levels has a pretty long cooldown. Still 40 seconds until Matumba Man can engage the Roche, well below half HP. If Liquid want to fight this, they do so without the Big Bad Wolf.
Oh, they're coming, though.
And they are moving towards the pit. Mind Control out in front. The smoke's going to break. They still hesitate. They don't walk in. They're waiting for the wolf, but it might be too late. No tell. Time walks out. He is slowing down the Roshan by not just hitting him.
He's scaring them with the Chrono, though.
But it works. And the Aegis goes to Miracle. Now Fada engages on to No Tail, but they don't have the follow-up burst. He's going to get the initiation off on to Fada with the Sunray going. The armlet still active. He drops quickly. The Dragon being brought down, but not finished off just yet. They can't kill him, and they Blade Fury spin forward. They will finish him off, and then the egg over the top. Zoning Liquid back as the Static Storm again ineffective. Miracle assassinates another. OG finding their stride. Almost getting Kuro there. OG.
Mind control.
And Aegis, two kills. And Liquid blew some ults.
Yeah, and it was a great blink crash from Mind Control on the back lines, but the Static Storm out of the Disruptor just wasn't there in time. I'm not sure if it was still on cooldown from the previous fight, but letting the Phoenix off the Supernova following the crash really secures OG's teamfight there. And suddenly No Tail, 2.9k gold, can complete the Battle Fury if he wants to. Still not sure this is really the optimal Void build these days. It used to be like a back in like the slow paced carry meta, you'd see Safelane Voids go Battle Fury, but as far as like a one position Void these days, you're much better like going for your Diffusal Mantis, so not sure what is exactly going to be on his mind.
Hard to say. At this point, it does seem like No Tail has changed his mind. He's up to well over the gold required for
Radiance, you know? I'm sure Wago will be happy. He's probably sitting backstage like, come on, No Tail, you can do it. Didn't get the Vanguard, but he's still very tanky even without it.
Ooh, gets the ultimate orb. So it looks like a Lincoln Sphere for the roar, the Dragon Tail, even the Glimpse potentially.
Lincoln's is great against DK stun, and like you mentioned, the Glimpse as well is often the catch. And the Lincoln's over time has been received a few small buffs here and there as far as the cost goes and even the cooldown on the Lincoln's refresh. So an item which is very defensive by nature, but it's amazing against Liquid's lineup.
Yeah, they know the most important thing here is to get off a good team fight and not to give up the pick, so Liquid don't have that power play. Yeah. And having the Lincolns is certainly a good way to ensure that.
I mean, now Void has a way to dodge the Glimpse. Jug does as well. Does put OG in a fairly safe position to...
They're streaming
the
bottom. Jug coming as well. They get the sounds off of Jerex. Which way does he go? It's Raptor for dinner. Miracle now dominating. Though I have to say, it feels like Crit is the one doing most of the heavy lifting.
OG ready to press forward, I imagine. Fortunately, we'll have to deal with some split push coming out from the Lycan always. There's a Necro 2 on both Kuro as well as Matumba Man.
So we have a kind of a pause, a lull in the action here, Gods. OG are going to look to push bottom, it appears. Liquid probably not going to contest this.
Well, they see Kuro. They may try and jump him here.
Is caught out. No Tail gets the jump. They commit even a Chrono for the forward position Beastmaster, but with the farm he's got, well worth it if they get the kill. No neutral deny. It goes the way of Fly. So, all right, now we have a moment. So, looking forward 10, 15 minutes down the road, does either team start to pull ahead? Is there a big power spike you're keeping your eyes out for? You mentioned the Necro Bolt timing hasn't really materialized for Liquid. Where are these teams looking next?
I mean, Liquid want to use their vision advantage to farm more of the map. Avoid OG's 5-man, split push up top, split push mid when you see this 5-man unit down bottom, and try and use these Necrobooks to slow down the OG push because it has such a high threat of breaching the OG high ground that OG will have to constantly TP back to defend this. For OG, it's all about finding those pickoffs. Using a Chrono on one hero is all about kind of asserting yourself over your opponent, saying, look, you're not going to split push. We're not going to let you play the economy game because that's exactly what Liquid's trying to do. Punish the fact that OG are 5-manning by just all four or five of their heroes are split apart farming different locations on the map. You had the Dragonite up top, you have the Lycan at the Ancients, you've got Disruptor bottom, someone else is farming the Radiant Jungle, so even if you lose one kill, you've got three or four other heroes farming.
And we have seen from Liquid that even from a bigger deficit than this, they can pull out some spectacular team fights. The series versus Newbie yesterday especially comes to mind with just incredible teamwork. And they do have some scouting tools here, not the Riki or the Bounty Hunter type hero, but they've got the Wolves, as well as the Amp Damage, the Hawk, so they have the Vision type here, as you mentioned, to not only create space for farm, but maybe eventually for that big team fight. They are, for now, trying to farm their jungle. OG pushing in the bottom lane. The Ward? The D ward just not been used yet. They haven't gotten vision up the cliff, it looks like.
I see a point booster picked up on No-Tail's Void, and I think he recognizes that the catch against the split push is going to be key. He wants that shorter cooldown.
OG streaming in. It's almost like Liquid wanted to bait this one. Crit. It's a trap. Static Storm getting dropped. A Miracle says, screw it, man. I'm going in. The Necro Book's there. The Omni Slash committed. He's got to run. Kills off the book, but he does get roared on the way out. Elsewhere, the bubble. No-Tail trying to lock down Matumba Man. Finish him off. The Wolf will fall. OG getting a core kill, but the Jug looks like he might jump. No! The Healing Ward, the Aegis! Enough to keep him alive for now, but eventually the Jug will fall.
Oh, the Aegis expired as they went on him. That burst heal was from the Aegis timing out, and Earth Spirit, like, crit kept him alive for longer, and it actually kind of bites OG in the ass there because they lose the Aegis because crit actually saved Miracle for like an extra 5 seconds, and that was so unfortunate.
That was a very interesting bait by Liquid. They saw the ward, they had the Hawk on top of the hill, it was in range of the sentry. They opted not to kill the ward. As soon as Earth Spirit rolls in, instantly the Static Storm comes out. Miracle dives pretty far with the Omni Slash, and Liquid are able to turn it. They get two cores. They do lose the Lycan again. But he's still up there as far as net worth goes.
Yeah, that's a great kill on Miracle's Jug, who's been involved in 8 of these kills. He was 8-1 before that, takes a death now, and he's picked up a Perseverance himself, although I wonder if he's thinking Battle Fury to help push out these lanes fast, deal with all the Necrobooks, the summons.
Double Lincolns feels like a bit defensive for OG, because this does appear to be a farm war.
I think you recognize what Liquid's trying to do and just farm the map, and you kind of do a bit of that yourself. While obviously being involved in kills, Miracle's going to smoke up with his team when, even without an Omni Slash, he can still be very influential.
And No-Tail now grabbing the point booster. So likely going to see that Ags has generally been Fata. In the Void build, and they are going to get eyes here on Fata. He pops the Shadow Blade, he tries to run, they glimpse it back. Do they have detection? You betcha. Can they finish him off, though? That's the question. Moon's there. Karate chops him down, making Moon Meander's mama very proud. Make it 2. And now OG can transition perhaps into a push. Tier 1 can just be backdoored here. Not sure if they get the Tier 2, though.
Could wait for the creep wave. There's not too big of a threat of the split push just yet from Matumba Man, although he will have full access to his jungle and potentially the bottom lane as well to threaten a counter push. But for now, it's crit. Being aggressive with a ward here, which does get scattered out being planted, so Liquid should be able to easily deward that one.
The Greaves are not picked up by Darkseer, and I think more importantly, you're up against Lycan Gods, you are up against a Hawk. They get the gem, so OG not having the best vision heroes on paper, but looking to really atone for that through the items.
Yeah. And just being able to punish as often as possible. This Chronosphere is going to quickly become less a teamfight tool and more a pickoff tool for OG. They want to use it to start fights. Even if you're just killing one core hero with a Chronosphere, you've still got plenty of teamfight to follow up the Void. If anything, Void needs to start the fight so Darkseer can come in later. Darkseer is not really a good teamfight initiator. He relies on the opponents to have already reacted and grouped up for that vacuum wall to come out. The way that fight at top breaks out is that Moon comes in after the initial fight and then hits that vacuum wall on the backline. So Void throwing an Aghanim's ulti just for one or two heroes on the front lines is more than adequate for OG in their team fight setup.
Big smoke by Liquid. Marching down mid. The Wolves scouting ahead, looking for prey, and they do see a Darkseer. A wild Moon appears. Aurora is there. Darkseer goes down. Clean execution by Liquid. And now they race forward, even popping the Wolf ult. Let's see where they roam next. I always like to hunt for these additional kills. They move into the pit, hoping, praying that Roshan is up. Their prayers are not answered.
Yeah, not
by Ice Frog.
Wonder if that was a misclick from Matumba, or just thought he maybe needed it for the. You see, the Darkseer Major expecting it to be backup, so I think it was just like a let's be safe rather than sorry kind of ultimate.
Well, one kill, instant tower down, and that's a pretty big one here. Tier 2 falls mid.
And that's the beauty of Liquid's draft, is that you can be the ones kind of in control, winning the farm war. Not really with map control, but you're the ones who have the strong team fight. But one pick off for Liquid, you take out a key team fight here, someone like a Darkseer or a Void, and suddenly your ability to breach high ground with the double Necrobooks, Dragonite ulti form is just brutal. And OG, they have to play very flawlessly here. They can't afford to miss a Chronosphere, to have a Darkseer get picked off too often, or suddenly Liquid, one big mistake near your base, and you find yourself losing a lane of racks.
Now, in good news for OG,
while they don't want to whiff Chronospheres, they have a little more wiggle room. It is now an Aghanim's online. So 1 minute cooldown. Not too much for Liquid to play around with, even if he does whiff one. They'll need to be very decisive in the punish.
There's still, like, to me, some slight concerns around their overall damage output. You look at the Void with Lincolns plus Ags. He's not really doing much damage output himself. Needs to transition
that
into
illusion. That. It got a whiff of OG trying to steal the Roche right under Liquid's eyes. Okay. And the Wolves, the fresh pack comes in. This Roche is not dropping quickly enough. They are going to have to fight. Fada moves up to the north under cover of Shadowblade, trying to move his way in, finding that pick. It would be big. A fresh pack emerges. When do they go? OG.
They know flies up here. They
slowly,
could silence him.
Slowly working on it. Liquid want to go in at exactly the right moment. The egg gets dropped very preemptively. Then the Chrono as well. They finish off the Roche. No tail. Trapping mind control in. And they manage to bring him down. And now the wall, the static storm too late. OG have found the Roche. They've gotten their Aegis. They've massacred two. They're looking for Fada as well. The team fight execution virtually flawless. Three down. Fada drops. Can they kill Crow two? Make it 4-1. And almost a lichen for dinner.
They just. They Liquid. Used their ultis like before Liquid were even on them. The egg comes out. As DK's trying to initiate in onto the Phoenix. And then you have a Chronosphere. He used Chrono before even the Slada blinked in. It's almost as if he expected them to be coming. Mind Control kind of blinks into it, and great ultimate usage from OG. They were so cautionary with it, making sure that they don't lose that one decisive Roche fight.
Yeah, getting the Aegis here and starting the fight with no Slardar, absolutely massive. He is the source of your sustained lockdown to deal with the Juggernaut, to deal with the Void, continue to get bashes, crits as the fight moves along, and boy, they're just lucky they didn't lose Mutumba Man too, but it's a pretty decisive win by OG Gods.
Sly did not mess around with his ulti uses there. That Phoenix Supernova, a lot of players would have tried to hold on, use a Sunray first perhaps, or use the fact that you're on that high ground to wait a bit longer before you throw out the Supernova, but he wanted to make sure that stun was popping around when Roche was dying. So OG pull further ahead off of that, almost a 10,000 gold lead now.
Well, it's easy to anticipate when you're a Time Lord, and that Faceless Void certainly is. So Liquid, 30 minutes in, almost nobody's been able to stop them when they get the Lycan. I mean, a Dragonite and Beastmaster on top of that. Normally towers just crumble even if you have a good start, but OG just haven't made a big mistake in any team fight. We haven't seen a whiffed Chrono, we haven't seen a whiffed Vacuum Wall. Occasionally a support will die, but it's been very mistake-free Dota, and 30 minutes in against Jerax's Disruptor, that is a tall order, but it's one OG have been up for the challenge.
Yeah, I mean, Liquid, a lot of their kills came in that early game where they found, like, they either traded kills in some kind of small skirmishes. They haven't found the key mid-game pickoffs outside of the one on the Darkseer. They kill the Darkseer, they immediately take a tier 2 tower. They need Radiant's more of that. Unfortunately, attack. Every time they've tried to smoke up, OG themselves have kind of been grouped as 5 ready to teamfight, and Liquid haven't exactly got the superior teamfight, assuming OG can get off their big ultis.
So what's next for OG? They have Aegis now. They are still out-farming Liquid as we see a jump top for Roar and the Miracle as the Blade Fury TP. Is he going to be able to get it off here? He goes for it. Just had the mana. It was close to Kuro burning it all away. But Miracle able to make it out. And it does show you the power of Beastmaster. Even down that much net worth can almost solo kill him.
That's a
gonna change though with this Eye of Scotty that's coming.
Yeah, risky place for Miracle to be. This is a nice item, gives him bigger mana pool to help deal with the Necrobooks, but more importantly, HP, armor, stats all across the board gonna be very useful for a Jug who likely wants to siege high ground. OG with like high ground sieges with Jugs have just been so good. They kind of go in, they time the Blade Fury so they can maximize their damage output, get back to safety, they use the healing ward really well.
And unlike most carries that don't have a BKB, he can just Blade Fury if they try to glimpse him in when he retreats.
I imagine they wanted the Aegis on Miracle. I think Notel having it was purely a reaction to the chaotic fight happening as Roche died. So it was very much a call, like, anyone who can pick up the Aegis, just make sure we grab it.
Well, he chronoed his teammates, so he's like, yeah, I'm going to have to take this. Sorry, buddy.
If he waits for the chrono to wear off, then if Mind Control somehow survives the chrono, maybe he gets it. You don't really have a guarantee Miracle's going to have to pick it up. The base trade scenario, very good response by Liquid. They've got Necrobooks. They push very fast.
I'm not sure if OG can do this, but they did get there significantly ahead.
They're already reacting. The Void's actually up top. If Liquid don't realize he's not pushing bottom, they could get caught out here.
Yeah, there is that glimpse back. It's only okay. 1 minute chrono, though. The glimpse back comes on Miracle. He has to Blade Fury and then run. Not like they're going to be able to follow up, it appears, though. You can see Mutumba Man already rotating.
It was a good call from Notel to kind of rotate back, TP himself home, and look for that catch of it. Liquid seem to be wary of it with their positioning, and OG claim a tier 3 tower uncontested.
Yeah, Miracle not entirely respecting the Jerax disruptor, but fortunately could still Blade Fury and just run. They didn't really have anyone to pursue him.
Even without a TP,
but both teams had the catch. Like, you have to be careful when you're going high ground.
Yeah. If Beastmaster TPs back, he's got a Blink Dagger. I think ideally Kuro needs to get Boots of Travel up as soon as possible. It's probably the kind of most impactful item that he can go following this Blink Necro book, just because of what it offers in terms of being able to threaten to split push, as well as after OG come back to defend the split push, you try and TP back and catch heroes like Miracle in that position. If he has Boots of Travel there, Miracle may have actually been out of being caught out.
You can see the stark contrast between the two four-position players this game. Kuro, he really took over last game on the Riki, but this game, it has been the crit show, involved in well over half of their kills, and most of them coming in those crucial early moments. So, with the Aegis now gone, No-Tail will use that inventory slot to buy a Blink Dagger. Does not opt to complete a Mjolnir or Sol Kuras. He wants the extra catch. And now he has it.
Yeah, if he has a Blink Dagger up top, that's a possible 2-3-man chrono.
Time walks in, Blink's on forward. This time it's a connection. It's onto Matumba Man. But four heroes are coming in reserve. Bada Sweeper out from the side. He's got a DD route. This dragon's going to hurt unless they can focus him. The Omni Slash very much unable to bring him down. And Miracle now getting stunned, turned on by Fada. He's still got the armlet active here, but he is fairly low. He's got to toggle this. No-Tail jumping in. Miracle staying alive through it all. It's the Moon Wall! Now they bring down the dragon, the wolf too, and they chase on the Jerax. It's about to be four. He tries for the TP. No escape from OG. Absolutely slaughtered.
So patient on Moon. He waited out both the Lycan BKB and the Dragon Knight BKB. Finds the exact timing at the end of that team fight to hit the vacuum wall. Ryze, it looked like things were starting to not go too well for OG. Suddenly, Moon shows up. That Darkseer play, catching Liquid completely by surprise. They just didn't get the kills during their BKB durations. Another very defensive supernova from Fly, but once you have that supernova Radiant by the tower, if Liquid commit for kills with BKBs, they're gonna get stunned up. And OG's teamfight, again, just shining. It's not just the Chronosphere that matters. It's the supernova, it's the vacuum wall, it's an Earth Spirit who can hit a multiple hero Boulder Smash. There's just too many teamfight spells coming out that Liquid just don't match up.
OG looking to take this game too. Reset the series at 1-1 and guarantee us a fourth game. They've taken one lane of Rax. Can they get more? Liquid smoking almost within their own fountain, really.
And OG already backed off with Chrono ready to go again. Wall up in 10 seconds, although they are a little bit short on mana for Moon.
They hold the line here bottom for now, but it's OG looking to come in, and there's the bubble. It's trouble for Matumba. No real help. No save just yet. The back comes through again. He has to BKB, and he runs. He's morphing into Big Bad Wolf, and he doesn't really want to be big or bad. He's just sitting back, unable to engage in this, fearing the follow-up damage. They focus Fly, though. He doesn't get off the egg. Maybe this is where Liquid make their stand. No-Tail dropping pretty fast. He does time walk back, and OG start to scramble the retreat. Liquid pursue. Miracle, though, has a Lincoln Sphere on top. He brings down the Necrobooks and they roll back in. Crit looking to engage. No-Tail out fairly far. Bada with the BKB, but he time walks it off. He continues to fight, and they bring down the dragon. They turn back for Kuroki. Well, Blade Fury Jerax, they might just kill them all here. Disruptor down. Crit surging in. He catches another. Continues to deliver. Silencing him, controlling him, and killing off his mind. OG unchecked in the team fights. And the crowd is loving it. Second lane of Rax is theirs. The game within their grasp, a desperation buyback. But can they hold? They have no Dragon Knight. They just now get the slaughter. There's no Wolf Ultimate. There's no ability
another
to take
chrono.
The fight. And it's Big Daddy again with the wall on top. The kick goes through from Crit. Mind control. It's about to be a dieback for him. Slardar down. Death by the Miracle Sword. And on to the Raindrax, perhaps onto more kills. Matumba Man running for dear life.
It's so nice to play a Void when you don't have to hit 5-man chronos, because No-Tail, we're seeing his initiation range. He initiates from like 1500 range away, uses a time walk into Blink Dagger just to catch one or two heroes. He catches a Lycan by itself, but he knows there's no pressure on him to hit more than one hero. If he just catches a Lycan, his job is to force a fight, force Liquid to engage on you, and then he knows he's got the backup of Supernova as well as Vacuum Wall to win the team fight, even without that big chrono. And it means OG just have this kind of unstoppable initiating force in the Faceless Void, and suddenly they get a second lane of Rakdos, looking to take a third and take game number two.
Miracle now imbued with the power of a butterfly as well. This is a gigantic Radiant's juggernaut. He just solo killed Radiant's a Dragonite essentially with the Omni Slash, basically the only damage hitting him in that last fight, and that was before this fresh tier 4 item comes out. So now all that stands between him and this game win is that Rax. But again, they're going to start with the Chrono. The Static Storm comes out to the side of the bubble. It doesn't matter. Spot is deleted. Liquid just never gets to fight with the whole team while the Green Dream persists. And they tap out. They can take no more. Liquid are swept aside here in game number two. We now have a real series on our hands.
And they even things up with a very impressive draft and just draft execution coming out. The rotations early on mid, pressuring Fatu's Dragonite. Fatu was such a key player in game number one, didn't get any opportunity.